We're building large telescope systems based on diffraction. The technology with diffraction would allow an entire large telescope to be fabricated with a very thin plate. And that thin plate that might be microns in thickness would be orders of magnitude, 1,000 times lighter than a large telescope. What we can do is layer many layers at the atomic or angstrom level and get the property that we want for the system. This corrector plate would allow all the colors to get refracted and be brought together so that you could see one image with all the spectral combinations in the image, so it would be sharp. I've been working a lot of adaptive optics, so we could incorporate either a static telescope where it's fixed or with electrically controlled. And NASA's interested because for planetary science and for solar physics, they need 10-meter, 20-meter telescopes. And it's very expensive, and it takes 10 years and often $1 billion to get a satellite up. These devices can be used in many ways. They could be used in adaptive optics, cameras. If we put the corrector plate, then all of this could be used in a commercial zoom lens. It could be used in portable telescope systems that hobbyists would use, and basically any optical system. Steve Horan is trying to set up a small sat. He wants to develop the vehicle, and my telescope and other technologies would be the payload. If we can get a small sat or some feasibility to verify the technology in the field, get it up to a higher TRL level, then Goddard would like to set up a flight experiment under the exploratory for the heliophysics. And this is a good time for heliophysics because the sun is acting up, and I'm just getting up to speed with all of that with the guys, but that's kind of exciting too. The physics is really interesting.